Finances! You make my head hurt when you talk of money. Now, change the subject.
All right. News from Rome. Octavian has forced Lepidus out of his command and into exile.
Wish I hadn't. Wish I had not drunk so much today.
So do I.
Do I trouble you, Rufio?
Yes, you do.
I wish you never found Caesar befuddled by wine. Nothing, no one ever befuddled Caesar.
Antony, the campaign against Parthia will not be an easy one.
How many legions have we left?
Well, it's hard to tell. None of them up to strength, so many desertions.
Desertions?
They haven't been paid in months.
You remember when we started into Greece? I lived with them, ate with them. I was one of them. They seem distant to me now as if they were a memory.
We must find the gold to pay them. The wheat to feed them, supplies, ships, armor.
Where do you suggest we look for all these?
I thought perhaps further to the east.
Syria.
Perhaps more to the south.
Ethiopia.
To the north of Ethiopia.
I forbid you to mention her.
I didn't.
I will not crawl to a hand held out like a beggar. Why has she not offered me assistance?
Perhaps she doesn't know.
Of course she knows. She knows everything. If only out of gratitude for what
perhaps,
I've done for her.
Perhaps she wishes to express it in person.
Then let her come to me. Am I so much less than Caesar?
Nor is she less than Cleopatra, queen of Egypt. And you
queens,
promised...
Queens, queens. Strip them as naked as any other woman. They're no longer queens.
It is also difficult to tell the rank of a naked general. Generals without armies are naked indeed.
All right. I meet her halfway. I send you to her. You order her to come to me.
If I am to order her, I need a big
dignity. Summon her.
Even worse.
Then beg, entreat, cajole. Find the word you like best. Pour perfume. Whinny like a stallion if you choose, but see that she comes to me.
I understand your position, Rufio. Surely you must understand mine. I do not intend to join that long list of queens who have quivered happily at being summoned by Lord Antony.
But surely I didn't say summon.
You said invite. He meant summon. In any case, I am the queen of Egypt, and I choose to remain on Egyptian soil.
Tarsus is not the other end of the world, Your Majesty.
If it were one step from Egypt, that would be too far. I will meet with Lord Antony, but only on Egyptian soil.
My lady, a way must be found, a time, a place to satisfy you both.
Must it, Rufio?
Never, except on Egyptian soil.
Never. Something women say to begin with.
You will welcome Queen Cleopatra on my behalf, Rufio. You will extend my invitation to a banquet in her honor at the palace
tonight. Don't you think perhaps
still not convinced, Rufio? Hurry back. There's much to be done. Have someone send the cooks to me.
Noble Root.